What's going on, world? Xtil Infamous here, bringing you what to expect in Apex Legends Season 22, Shockwave. Thank you to EA, EA Creator Network, and Respawn for the opportunity to preview the new season. This season, Apex will be introducing a new map, E-District. E-District will be Apex Legends' sixth map. With 17 POIs, this will be the most densely packed map to date. It has more playable space than any other map due to the multi-layered architecture. For legend changes, controller and recon legends are getting reworked this season. Controller legends will now have zone overcharge, which grants an extra 25 shield when in zone. It will refill automatically and will disappear if you leave zone. In addition, controller legends are getting a quality of life update called remote pickup. You can remotely pick up any undamaged tech charges by looking at them and pressing a button. If you leave an area altogether, you can recall all undamaged charges the same way. Recon Legends survey beacons are getting updated. Beacon spawn rates are getting increased. They will be faster to use. The world scan feedback is being updated. The scan will be refreshed multiple times over 15 seconds. The scan range will be reduced from 500 meters, nerfing Evo gain to 75 to combat this. In addition, threat vision will be added to all recon legends while aiming down sights. It requires the line of sight and does not highlight through blockers like bang smoke. Meta changes will be coming this season for certain legends: Rampart, Watson, Crypto, and Vanish, just to name a few. For weapon changes, aim assist for controller will be nerfed about 25% in PC lobby and cross play from console to PC lobby. Console only lobbies will not be affected. Aim flinch is being removed from weapons and most legend abilities. Ring damage will continue to apply flinch. Mantling and climbing on teammates have been updated and now work as intended. Eva 8 is going back on ground and the R9 will be going in the care package. Akimbo weapons are coming this season for the P20 and Mozam. Any attachment you find will mirror the second weapon, so there is no reason to loot for two mags. In Akimbo state, the P20 and Mozam are automatic, have increased fire rate, and replaces the traditional ADS with a Titan hipfire. LMGs are getting buffed by adding a hop-up called Gun Shield Generator, which creates a weapon shield in front of you when you aim down your sight. The shield will absorb up to 40 damage, and when it breaks, it will go on a short cooldown and regenerate. In addition to the new hop-up, LMGs have been improved for close-quarter combat. The reverse hipfire mechanic has been added to all LMGs, which is currently found on the care package Devotion. Shotguns are getting buffed. The Mastiff and PK are losing a few pellets, but will have their damage per pellet increased to compensate, keeping the damage on par for what is currently done in game. PK Bass pattern has also been updated. The Havoc is getting a hipfire nerf. The Hemlock is getting nerfed. It's getting nerfed by reducing damage from 20 to 19, increases the time between bursts, a slight nerf to the white and blue mag capacity. Ammo stacks are getting an update as well. Light ammo will now stack from 60 to 72. Shotgun ammo will now stack to 20. Energy ammo now stacks to 54. A handful of light weapons will be receiving a mag capacity increase across all mag rarities. For rank changes, your ending RP will dictate your starting RP for Shockwave. RP this season will be increased. 15th place and above will have no RP loss. There will be a small RP gain for kills. The map rotation for pubs and rank are E-District, Broken Moon, and Stormpoint. For everything coming this season to Apex Legends, improved battle sense mechanics are coming this season to regular and rank BR. Visible health bars on damage and enemy highlights at close range. When the enemy is out of line of sight, it will disappear. Death box layouts are getting reworked for better looting. The battle pass has been cut to 60 levels. There will be one battle pass per split. Rewards are being revamped. Rewards will feature the content players want or feature currency so players can get the content they want. Split 1 Premium Battle Pass will be offered for free after completing challenges. Players are able to buy the split battle passes with 950 Apex coins. Midway through game, all open loot bins will be reset. Loot bins will reroll their loot, close back up, and give squads a fresh bin. Gold and mythic bins are being introduced. Each map will have one mythic bin that will be shown on the map, and it takes longer than a normal bin to open. Welcome passes are being introduced for new players that create their accounts after the start of Season 22, which includes 7 days of challenges that will help teach and reinforce core skills. Game modes this season. This season, we will be introduced to Stray Shot Revival. Stray Shot Revival drops early this season. When you die in-game, a respawn timer kicks in as long as you have one living teammate. You will respawn near them when the timer ends. Getting damage and knocks will bring back your squad mates faster. You will have unlimited revivals until the end of round 4. Bot Royale will be introduced this season and available to everyone. You can play by yourself or get bot squad mates or bring a squad. All legends are available. It replaces the orientation matches. You will not gain any XP if you're over level 10. And you won't be able to progress your seasonal challenges or badges. There will be two rank rumbles each season. One at the split and the other at the end of the season. Your rank for rumble will be based off your best 10 matches. There are no re-entry required. Regular rank will be put on hold during each rumble. How you play in rank rumble will not impact your RP. And as always, if you haven't already, make sure to like and sub. Until next time, I'm XStillInfamous. Thanks for watching. Peace.